Hello there, everybody. Welcome back. Today, I'm going to be using the custom league feature that was added in this game, and I used it a lot at the beginning and then really just abandoned it. So we're coming full circle and we're using it again today. We're going to go all the way down to six teams. And on top of that, I am going to max out the salary cap. I'll keep the minimum where it is. I don't think that's going to matter, but we will go all the way up to 125 million per team. Everything else I'll just leave as is. That's the only thing I want to change. But I do want to turn on the expanded pool, of course. That's the whole point. With only six potential teams, let's find out who we are going to be using for today's drafts. It is the, boom, New York Rangers. I'm actually pretty excited about that. If I could just snap my fingers and get a jersey right now, it would be a Rangers jersey. They are sick. Some might even call them timeless. All right, the reason we're here is to make sure Jabroni does not touch my lines. And then this is also kind of important, I suppose. Fog of War, no thank you. I'll leave player morale off in this one. Obviously, we want owner mode to be off as well. Okay, everything looks good. I don't really know why, but I feel like this draft format, we're just gonna get waxed by the entire league. I see us coming last. But anyway, there's only six, so the chances of me guessing our draft position go up drastically. I'm gonna say we get pick number four. Let's find out how wrong I am. The New York Rangers will be drafting second overall. Nice. Now, obviously, before this, we weren't able to take players like Leon Draisaitl because he plays for the Edmonton Oilers, and we'd have to put the Oilers in the league to be able to draft these players, but now we can draft anybody. I genuinely just went to my YouTube playlist to make sure I haven't already made this video because it feels familiar, but by the looks of it, I haven't done it yet. Maybe I had the idea and just never actually followed through. Regardless, we're taking Leo first overall because this guy is an absolute animal. Okay, well, not first overall, second overall, but our first pick. There you go. Vasilevsky is still there, but I just feel like goalies never really do that much. No, I'm not going to do it. Marner and Draisaitl playing together should be illegal. So today we're committing a crime. Let's go, Marnsey. Yeah, let's go with a defenseman. Victor Hedman or Rasmus Dahlino is the cue of the day. Because Dahlin is nasty. He's only making 6 million. Hedman's just Hedman, though. Let's go with Victor. Another reason not to take a goalie super soon is because there's not that many teams. They're not going to fall off that quick. So we have tons of time. Yeah. Okay, yeah. This just in, Victor Hedman's playing with John Carlson. We're basically constructing an all-star team. In fact, everybody here is, but I need a left winger. Do you think it would be bad to have two snipers on the first line? Ovi paired with Draisaitl. It's hard to say. Landeskog power forward could really complete that line. And Kyle Connor is just an absolute legend of the game. Okay, you know what? I'm going to take Landy just so we have the player type diversity. And honestly, what better way to start off the second line than with Brady Tkachuk? Whoever took Matthew Tkachuk probably wants to reunite them. So I'm going to spoil that, even though it's an AI drafting and they have no intention of doing any such thing. All right, all right. There's only 190 overall goalie left, so we'll go with Jake Oettinger. Got him. We took Brady Tkachuk for the second line. We could take Zibanejad or Zibanejad. It's one of the two. He's a center sniper. Feels weird to have two centers that snipe, and I'm here for it. Let's go, Mika. Will Nye, the hockey guy, playmaker on that line. Our top six is disgusting. Let's go with some Devin Taves action. 88 overall. Seems like a solid pick to me. And he is going to be paired with Doug the Thug Hamilton. It just doesn't really work. This is great. Thank you for the idea, because I am flying through this thing. Matthew Barzal still only 25. Why do I think he was a lot older than that? Well, he's going to be our third line center. I'll tell you that for free. We have $34 million of cap space left, which isn't really a cause for concern, but at the same time should not be ignored. Oh no. Do I take Tuck or do I take Meyer? A year younger, making less. Tuck is a power forward. Meyer's got three. Oh, they're both power forwards and Meyer has more abilities. Okay. I got to go with Timo. Whoa, this guy got an overall bump. Big time. 87 overall for Rasmus Anderson. I'm going to go with Kevin Fiala. Huberto down to 88. That hurts. I really want to draft Nick Suzuki. Although he's a playmaker. Probably work on the fourth line, no? 2.5-star physical? Maybe not. I think it would be really wise of me to take Samsonov here because he's making 1.8. And yeah, $24 million of cap space with a decent amount of picks left. Could be concerning. Well, not really concerning. I'm sure we'll find players. 100% we'll find players, because there's six teams in the league. But anyway, making that selection, and we only have, what is it, five to go? Troy Terry, two-way forward, making 1.4. That's lovely. What's his defensive category? 4 stars? That's good enough. Yep, signing him up. The chemistry on these teams has to be ridiculous, no? Ryan O'Reilly making 1.8. How can I say no to that? All right, scratch everything I said before the draft. We are cleaning up this league. This is our league, as a matter of fact. Kuzmenko, fourth line sniper. Sure, let's get some depth goal scoring. And you want to know part of the reason I did that? Is because we can take Erik Karlsson, EK65, 11.5 million. Who cares? Not this guy. We need one more left-handed defenseman. Montour's right-handed? He is. Hard to say no to that. It's got an X-factor, 2 abilities, shoots left, 5.7. It pretty much works out perfectly. We're so good. All right, your New York Rangers. That is quite the roster. We also got Shane Wright back there. And we got Matthew Savoie, Moser, Tomasino, Peyton Krebs. Jeez. Sim up to the regular season. We're still playing 82 games just against 5 other teams. Time to find out what our chemistry's looking like. Watch it be terrible. Okay, so the last line is not good, but I'll take 0. I've had, like, -3 before. I am going to veto this. Yeah. Because that way we get 2 plus 5s. So that works out splendidly. I'm pretty sure Zibanejad was he supposed to be the third line center? I don't even know anymore. It's all a blur. If I move Timo Meier down to the 4th line, we get a +3. And it's roll 4 lines, so they're gonna be getting minutes. Alright, yeah, I'm down. What a roster. Defense. We have Victor Hedman playing with EK65. Why are they a 0? What's up with all that? Who hates this team? Victor? I'll allow it. We have a 2-way defender and then an offensive defender. Boom. And I'm pretty sure Pelik is defensive. Yeah. Okay. No, I'm going to leave it as it is. And in the cage, we have Jake Ottinger backed up by Ilya Samsonov. What a team we have here. I have no idea how we're going to perform or what the other teams look like, so 48 wins. We're going to be sick. That might be a little bit aggressive. Slightly. Simulate up to the trade deadline. See where we're at. Oh, come on. Never mind. They brought us right back down. I love how fast the simulation speed is in this, too. Impeccable. This right here very well might take the cake for my favorite draft of all time. Because it was just so easy. And the simulation speed is motoring. It's all clicking. We are in first place by 11 points. We got this. I truly undersold this team with 48 wins because we're already at 42 and it's deadline time. Let's just keep our trading block. I'm not going to make any moves. We're too good. But let's see who's available. It's got to be outrageous. Well, no. I'm not trading any of those guys. We could go after Georgiev. I'm just simply not going to do that. We could go after Morgan Riley. My favorite Leaf, also not going to do that. Here's your big trades. We got Edvinson and a third headed to Montreal in exchange for Eklund and a third. Let's get this season finished up and find out how ridiculous the numbers are. 52 wins to finish the year, a first place landslide. And we get the Habs, the Montreal Canadiens, first round matchup. Here we go. I am really curious to see if the goalies are going to have good stats or not. It came down to the wire between these three. What kind of roster are we looking at here? You got 45 wins. You have Ovechkin, McKinnon, and ADB. Matthew Tkachuk, so there you go. Found out who I took the brother from. Eichel and Huberto. Marchie, Sebastian, Tage. Like, ew. What made Boston so bad? They have Kaprizov playing with Matthews and Robert Thomas. Hintz, Goudreau, and Svechnikov. They grab Suzuki. All right, yeah, I guess it kind of makes sense. Surprisingly, not a lot of points. Teams shut it down defensively. Point a game for Marnsey, but then we drop off to 64 for Barzal, 59 for Leo. Hedman at 58. What's going on? Jakey O, 915 save percentage, 270 GAA, Samsonov, great backup numbers, can't complain. All right, what are we looking at here? Jake led the league, obviously. What a save percentage from Logan Thompson, although he did only play 23 games, so you can't count it. Hedman led defenseman, just another category that we're leading in. Not a big deal. Kale McCarr had 55 points, 54 for EK. So we have two of the top three defensemen. Is that any good? McDusty led the league with 93 points. No surprises here. Marnsey second, though. Kaprizov at number three, almost point a game. Just shy. Jack Hughes had 77. He must have got an overall bump. Yeah, he deserved it. Last I remember, he was 88. He might have been 90 for a while now, and I just haven't really been paying attention. But if he recently got bumped, he absolutely deserved it. So with only four teams qualifying, we only get two rounds of playoffs. Let's find out how the first one goes. I'm calling a no sweep. It's a best of three. One game at a time, baby. Oh, no. Of course. Let's go Rangers. We gotta take it home at the Bell Center. Bring it back to MSG. Bada bing, bada boom. Let's go Johnny C. Back-to-back power plays for the Canadians. We killed it off and some depth goal scoring to boot. All right. Let's chill out, Jacob. Who invited you? Who do you even know here? Nice way to start the second period for Johnny C once again. Phenomenal play from him in this matchup so far. 5-on-3. The longest 5-on-4 ever. A hat trick for John Carlson. Somebody give this man a hat. 3-goal lead heading into the third period. We just got to shut it down now. Should be a pretty textbook win. Headed back to New York for game number 7. Yep, we really did a good job of shutting her down in that third period. To be fair, so did they. There was no goals. Here's your 3 stars. Absolute beautician. I turned injuries off, but apparently John Carlson's injured. He has a contusion in his back from carrying the boys. The other series went to 7 as well. Wow, all right. Here we go. Round 1. Technically like the conference finals. Or the third round in a normal playoffs. Let's go. Our defense. Getting the job done. What a weird place to score from too. All the way over on the boards. Ooh, Marnsey. Gonna give us the 2-goal lead. Heading into period number 2. Nice. Dougie Hamilton. What is with our defense? Getting all the points. Who needs offense at this point? Maybe defense is the best offense. Oh no. Never mind. That was us. Timo. Boom. We got it unlocked. We are headed to the... Nice try, Matty. But your team's Dunyans. So Montreal may or may not have just killed off a 5-on-3, which may or may not give them some momentum to get back into this thing. No, they're toast. 3 goals, 5 minutes left. The Rangers are moving on to the Stanley Cup Finals. Will we be facing Detroit or will we be facing Chicago? Let's find out. The 3 stars of the game are brought to you by Raid Shat... No, I'm just kidding. But, yeah, there they are. The Big Apple going head-to-head against the Windy City. I'm simulating the first 3 games. That's not a good start. We gotta win this one, make it a best of three. Oh, dear. We got this, Rangers! Come on, we were down last series. Maybe we don't got this. Chicago finished 2nd in the league, right? They also get a power play goal. Oh, this is what it is. It's spiteful that I took Brady. Okay. All right, I see you. Tell you what. You let me win the Stanley Cup? I'll send Brady over your way for a bag of pucks. Is that a good deal? Oh no, of course Marchy scores to start the third period. They're just too much for Mr. Incredible. Chicago is gonna go on to win the Stanley Cup. Unless we have some kind of miraculous comeback here. It is all but over. And it wasn't even a struggle for them. It took 5 games. Absolutely outrageous. But hats off to clearly the better team. Linus Ullmark as well. This is just the slap me in the face team because could have drafted him. I taunted with the 90 overall and then went to Jake Yeo. So, you know what? I had this coming. Fair enough. Well, regardless, I had a lot of fun with that one. Let's go look at some playoff stats and awards. Linus Ullmark had himself a run. 12 games played, a 913 save percentage. Jake Oettinger just shy of the 900. Got a 931 from Katahat, but he only played 2 games, and I guess it was in relief for Vazzy, who was not having a good time. Pietrangelo gets 11 points in 12 games. And then the man, the myth, the legend, John Carlson puts up 9. Good stuff. Devin Taves right there with 7. Chuck E. Cheese gets the Conn Smythe, no doubt about it. 16 points in 12 games. Sebi with a point a game run. Same with Tage, Mitchie, and Brad. Team awards, we are aware. Individually, we know some of them, but not all. Art Ross goes to Connor. So does the Heart. Victor Hedman. Nice. Gets the Norris. Marnsey with the Lady Bang. Owen Power gets the Calder. That's cool. Conn Smythe goes to Chuck E. Cheese, as I said. Jake Ottinger with the Vezina and the Jennings. Boom. At least we're getting some hardware here. Petrangelo gets the Masterton. Bon Voyage gets the Jack Adams. The Selkie goes to Barkov. Yep, that checks out. McDusty with the Ted Lindsay, and he also gets the Rocket Richard. Not a big deal. All right, so here is your very minimalistic playoff tree. Rangers and Montreal. Chicago, Detroit went to seven, and then the Stanley Cup Finals was a rinse fest. But hey, I had a good time still. If you have any other draft suggestions, be sure to leave them down below. Thank you so much for this recommendation, and thank you guys for watching the videos. I'm glad you're enjoying them. And yeah, on that note, I will see you soon.